The gentleman in question has been certified, gone to court, won those claims, and so I'm not sure why we're debating this at all.
This motion to lay on the table is not debatable, and I ask that the motion be put to a vote immediately.
The chair does not recognize the amendment introduced by Senator Ament. The chair recognizes Senator Ament.
Mr. President, point of order, I didn't offer an amendment. Mr. President, it's your duty to put a motion properly before this body. If you continue to refuse to perform your duties, the Senate will proceed to replace you with the interim president pro tempore pursuant to the Senate's power.
Breaking the Constitution and the laws of the Commonwealth and violating the oath of office you've actually taken. There's no roll call vote, Mr. President. It has not been acknowledged, has not been recognized. It is inappropriate to do such. We will not participate in this farce.
Joining us now is Pennsylvania's Democratic Lieutenant Governor John Fetterman. Lieutenant Governor, thank you very much for being here. Can you just explain that chaos that we're hearing? Whose voice is that? And what was happening in the room?
Absolutely. Well, it was very simple. Yesterday was like picture day in the Senate. All the new elected senators or reelected senators are joined. It's really a ceremonial kind of function. And unfortunately, our colleagues on the Republican side decided that one of the state senators, who happens to coincidentally be my own state senator, they refused to seat him despite being certified, despite presenting the identical credentialing that any other senator of either party that was sworn in yesterday. And that decision was affirmed by the Supreme Court. They refused to seat him. And ultimately, I refused to entertain the motion to table his nomination. And then that's when chaos erupted. The voice you hear loudly is actually my colleague, Senator Anthony Williams of Philadelphia.
Yes, but what the Republicans say is that there were, I suppose, some balloting issues with this reelection win of this Democrat, and that those are making their way through federal court. So is that fair to let it wait until that's resolved?
Absolutely not. These are all baseless allegations and lies, much like the ones you're going to hear in the nation's capital by people that know that they're lying. It's part of this toxic culture that has seeped into our political discourse, where you have a party willing to subvert basic core democracy. You know, Senator Brewster was elected democratically by his constituents. The results were certified by the Secretary of State. And our Supreme Court was democratically elected by the people of Pennsylvania. You know, at some point, you have to call it what it is. And that's subverting the democratic will of the citizens of Pennsylvania.
And so why were you removed from the proceedings? And should you have done something differently? I mean, I understand that you didn't recognize the president pro tem. Should you have done something different?
No, I did exactly what I needed to do, and that was I refused to entertain the motion. And their only procedural move was to vote to have me removed. And I could have played that out longer and longer, and that would have created more and more chaos. But the core that we needed to achieve was drawing out Senator Brewster to the front with all the other senators and giving him the opportunity to be sworn in, because, again, he's presenting the same identical credential. And it just forced the Republicans to create this spectacle in which they are, again, subverting the democratic will of Pennsylvanians. And there was no justification for what happened yesterday. It didn't have to happen. Every exertion was made from the highest levels on down to avoid that. Senator Brewster, if those court cases would have gone against his favor, would have happily stepped down. This was simply a bizarre flex by the majority to order to create an environment that is compatible and is similar to the one that the president is trying to create in Washington all across the country.
Well, let me ask you about that, because we just had former Congressman, Pennsylvania Congressman Charlie Dent on our program earlier. He was in the Pennsylvania State Senate for 6 years, and he said that he'd seen a situation like this before. Somebody was seated, but then the federal court unseated them. And so is this something that comes up from time to time in Pennsylvania, or are you saying that there's something contagious happening from Washington, D.C., and the obstruction there?
What I'm saying is that, as Mr. Dent noted, the senator was seated. And then when the court case came through, he ultimately was switched. And that illustrates what is the way it's supposed to work. What happened, let me be clear, what happened yesterday is unprecedented in the Pennsylvania State Senate history, without a doubt. And you know, I certainly didn't want it to come to that. It just was, because the majority refused to adhere to the Democratic will of not only Senator Brewster's constituents, but also the will of Pennsylvania. You simply can't ignore democracy and an outcome simply because you don't like it or you don't agree with it.
Well,
that's not your role.
I mean,
your role is,
you know, tell that to what's happening in Congress today. I mean, very quickly, what do you think is about we're about to see today in Washington, D.C.?
Yeah, we're going to have 8 out of our 9 congressional Republican delegation down in Washington lying and simping for the president when they know better than anybody that there was no fraud. And you want to know how I know? Because they accepted the results in their race. They want you to believe, and they're going to stand up in public and say, my race didn't have any fraud, but oh, that Joe Biden, Scott Perry had a highly contested race. Scott Perry is going to allege that there was no fraud in his race, but there was all the fraud in the world for Joe Biden. It's logically, ethically, and morally repugnant.
Lieutenant Governor John Fetterman, thank you very much. We appreciate you explaining everything that happened yesterday and what we'll be seeing today.